Hey, hi guys. Today I'll be showing you how to deploy Unity Catalog on Databricks. Let's get started. So right now I'm in my Azure portal. I'm gonna start with creating an Azure Databricks workspace. So let's go ahead and do that. Azure Databricks, and we can create an Azure Databricks workspace. The resource group, I will create a new one, and I'm gonna call it RG. SEA, ADB, 01. Click OK. And for the workspace name, I will go with Azure Databricks, SEA, and 01. The region that I'll be using is the Southeast Asia region. To set up Unity Catalog, you will require a premium pricing tier. So we'll go ahead and leave that selected at premium. Let's see, I think we can just go forward, review and create. Okay, deploy Azure tags, none. So let's validate. Once the validation is succeeded, then we can go ahead and create our workspace. So while this is deploying, we will go ahead and create our storage account. Storage accounts. So create storage account. And the storage account name, I will go with SA storage account ADB and 01. For the primary service, we'll go with Data Lake Storage Gen2. For Unity Catalog, you're also going to require a premium performance account in terms of storage account. So we'll leave it at premium. For the premium account type, let's go with block blobs. LRS is fine. You'd only go with ZRS for production environments if you actually ask me. So that would ensure that if there are any failures, then there are backups in place. But for our use case at the moment, LRS is fine. Let's go enable hierarchical work namespace. Yep, we want this selected. Next. Enable public access from all networks, that's fine. I would usually select public access from selected virtual networks if I was using an enterprise account. But yeah, I mean, for this use case, public networks is fine. Go ahead and click next. So, all right, next. I would usually go for customer managed keys if this was an enterprise account, but yeah, Microsoft managed keys is fine at the moment. Tags, I don't think I have any tags. Review and create. So let's see. So now I'll just go ahead and create the storage account as well. And so while this is deploying, let's go ahead and create our third most important item, the Azure Access Connector, Azure Databricks. Right, I believe this is recent. An Access Connector does get automatically created, which is fantastic. So we'll proceed with this Unity Catalog Access Connector, that seems fine. All right, so let's go back home. Go to my storage account, DB storage. Recently created storage account. And we will go to containers, create a new container. Nothing advanced, just create. And I will then go to properties. Right, thank you. Select Metastore and also copy the URL. Copy the URL and Metastore is in there. Container is also Metastore, so that's fine. And let's go back home. Go to the Access Connector again. From here, I am going to copy the resource ID. I'll be needing that later. Next, I will go to the accounts page. So let's copy that. Hi guys. So yesterday there was some issues that I realized. Turns out you cannot access the accounts console unless you have an enterprise account or a work account. So currently I've switched it to my work account. And yeah, let's continue with the setup process. So the next thing I'm going to do is just go back and check that we have all the required resource names. And then I will go to my accounts console. And so you will need to be a global administrator on Azure platform using your work account. And so here, I'll sign in. Okay, now I'll go to catalog and I will create, since up there is an example Metastore. This is you can only create one Metastore per region, and I'm just going to create another Metastore because I don't believe this has been assigned yet. Workspaces. Oh, it has. Wow. Just delete this Metastore. Let's just delete this. And then I'll create a Metastore. Metastore. The region we will select again, Southeast Asia. And for the access connector, we'll go with the one we copied. So, once again, you can get this access connector ID. Just going to the access connectors. You can also see that the resource group is matching with the one we created, which is under the RG-ADD-SEA. And you go in here and select the resource ID from here. So go ahead and do that. And we'll add it in and Metastore. Storage account name will be our storage account. And .dfs.conf. Location for storing many table data across all catalogs in the Metastore here. Create. So it seems we have a couple of access validations, but I will continue to do a false create. Okay, and then we'll assign it to the our workspace. It. Let's go ahead and create an example. Alright, I'm back in my workspace. Go ahead to the compute. Create and compute. I'll go ahead and create a simple user. I will need to ensure that this is enabled with Unity Catalog. So we're back, and right now I am creating my cluster. What we want to make sure is that it's Unity Catalog enabled, and I'm going with the least settings. So now at the standard compute, and I've gone ahead and created my compute. So let's wait for it to start up. Let's go back to the workspace. And I'm just going to create a new notebook. Let's try connecting to the cluster. Okay, so after I've cleaned up the data set, then I'm going to click on run. Okay, we can see that we have our first data set. And I'm going to create an example catalog. So create catalog. Okay. And then we're going to use catalog. So we're back here, and right now I also need to create a schema. So I'm just going to create a schema called metastore.demo.data. And this is usually good practice because, especially with Unity Catalog, we have a tree naming workspace. I'm going to create the schema here, and it's great. So now we will try writing the data frame that we just created into our data. And call the table the test data table. So let's try that. So we're back here, and we are in our catalog. I've just created a schema called under the catalog that we just created called data. And next, I am going to save the data frame that we just wrote into a table called test data. And because we're using Unity Catalog, it's a tree name hierarchical namespace. All right, I hope I got that right. And let's just click run and see if we manage to save our table. So, all right, there is a section where you can go right here called the catalog. And if I were to go into the Metastore demo section, I can actually see that our schema has been created, and under that schema we also have our test data. So let's check one more time if we can access it. So let's try it. Select all. There's a neat trick here. Okay, you just click on this arrow button, it will insert the table for you. And yeah, once we query the table, we can actually see that the data is there and it is present. So let's go ahead and try opening this in the Catalog Explorer. Okay, so as you can see, once we've opened it in the Catalog Explorer, we can see that this has been saved to our default storage location, the Metastore container which we created earlier, and also it's a managed table. So that's it. I hope you enjoyed this session of setting up Unity Catalog on Databricks, and I hope to see you in the next one. Thanks.